Now, I think we're coming into a new era of education. You know, my one boy who's a little out there kind of thing. I mean, that was it. He taught himself everything. Instead of going to classes, he was able to teach himself everything. He hardly went to classes and was in engineering and math and stuff like that. And now, most people I talk with that have done things and made businesses out of products they designed, they weren't engineers. They didn't learn how to do this stuff in school. They taught themselves because they wanted to do it. You know, just the desire to want to do it. And now, this next video, you see, will help somebody teach you how to code, like, games, 3D computer games, you know, because you want to do it. They said, easy, anybody could do it, and that's where we're leading to. Instead of going to a school somewhere, you know, getting a degree in it. No, with a desire, we could all learn how to do things in life. And that's what it takes, desire. So something you really want to learn, you'll figure it out. And actually for coding, being able to code nowadays, I mean, there for every job, there's 5 jobs available for everyone who can fulfill it. So we're needing people who know how to computer code so badly in our country. You think it's going to Europe or going to China or going to India? No, it's here. We can't get enough coders here. So here's a way, you know, you could go online and take courses yourself. They're easier, more fun, because nobody's has to deal with a bureaucracy, you know, to make it boring. Anytime you have to deal with a big organization, you're going to bore the hell out of the thing you're doing, right? If it's yourself thinking of a fun way to do it and don't have to answer to anything but the end customer like you, you make it fun because that's what you would want to do. So that's why this era that we live in now, that everyone can learn themselves without having to go to some huge institution to learn it. And so coding is a wonderful skill we all need, you know, even if it's for personal or to start a whole new career. So here's a guy who got really $70,000 on the internet, you know, to show people how to code themselves with no background, no engineering degree, no degree at all or whatever. You just want to learn. So watch him. Well, Ben Tristram, and you're with CompleteUnityDeveloper.com. But more importantly, it looks like, you know, you have an interesting life. Not only have you created a product where people can teach themselves coding computer games, right, in 3D, you figured out how to get, what is it, almost $60,000, you know, on the internet to help you start that business of your course, you know, when you only thought you needed like $6,000, and the people were... said, hey, you know, Ben, you're stupid. You need 60. You don't need 6. So really, well, let's talk about the course first, because that's interesting. So this is a course that anybody, I mean, I don't have to need a computer science degree to teach myself this stuff.
No, we are starting basic, real basic, with the programming. If you're willing to learn, if you're willing to go over the obstacles, you can learn to code. Your biggest obstacle is going to be yourself, right? When you do this, anybody who can read and who's got half a brain could do it. The question is, are they going to get in their own way? So if you're willing to do the difficult work and to get out of your own way, then we will make sure the learning journey is like this. It starts shallow and gets steep. So, yeah, anybody in principle can do it.
Well, I think, I mean, the older I get, the more I see that's really true, because I look around and look at all the idiots doing cool things, you know? I mean, they're not brilliant. They're not Einsteins. They just took the time to figure it out. So that's what the rest of us have to do. We don't have to spend big money. And like, your course is $200, but right now, because you're not finished with the last chapter or two, people could use it for like under $50, right? And start learning this, and within 60 days or 30 days, it'll all be there by the time you get to chapter 5 or 6 or whatever it is. So it's online you use this, right?
Yeah, exactly. It's an online course. You sit down, you study at your own pace. And we're just rewarding people for coming in earlier. The earlier they invest in the course, the cheaper they get it, because we get really, really useful feedback. So the 1,500 people who backed that Kickstarter, most of them are already in the course now, and they're watching it, they're consuming it, they're giving us feedback, they're reviewing it with 4- and 5-star reviews, mainly 5-star. And it's great. And that feedback we get means we can set the path for the rest of the course without kind of making big batch mistakes. If we've done something wrong, they tell us real quick. They're really keen to tell us, and we fix it.
And so that so I get a big deal, you know, by being helpful for you too, by complaining if something's wrong, which you want to hear, right? So you could fix it.
Absolutely. And because it's early enough to fix it, we actually can immediately turn around and respond and fix it. So the quality now, because of all this feedback, is just going through the roof. So it's already the biggest and already the highest quality course on game development on Udemy. And Udemy is the biggest online learning platform that I know of. So it's cool. I'm really pleased with it so far.
Well, what's interesting to me is that it's your clients and customers that really make you smart in this world, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, they tell you, if you're out there and you have customers, they tell you what they want. Here you sit, you know, before you start something, you're guessing, and you ask your mother-in-law and she doesn't know, and or gives you something stupid you can't use. And so you're going out with customers. But now the other part of your life is that, is this your first venture in fundraising on the internet?
Yes, first Kickstarter. Yep. We didn't think about it very long. We just said, look, no point in making a course unless we know people want it. So let's check if they want it. Let's stick up a very ropey video on Kickstarter and see if there's interest. And there was 10 times more interest than we could have even hoped for. So, but yeah, it's my first venture, and I learned a lot from it. Certainly glad I did it.
Now, the video is a cute, wholesome, and authentic video. Did you have like a big production company help you with that or things like that?
Absolutely not. No. I used the webcam I'm talking to you now on, right?
Really? That's it, huh?
We did actually plan to re-record it. When it got past $10,000, $20,000, $30,000, we were like, this video doesn't suit anymore. But my partner, my business partner, he had a family emergency. He was in France.
So, in other words, so you said your partner was in France, so you couldn't re-record it, and so you just left it as it is, and you got $60,000 no matter what it is. Why'd you want to change it? I mean, that seems silly.
Exactly. That's true. It's just nerves, right?
But now, so what other advice do you have for people that, hey, I think I want to use this crowdfunding Kickstarter stuff or whatever, but, you know, I'm afraid. So what do you think they should know?
Okay, well... Firstly, pick your platform, right? Just understand that this is advice I'm giving, but I didn't use. So I didn't understand anything about the market. The only one I'd heard of was Kickstarter. And if what you're offering is less than a few hundred dollars and is to consumers and is of international appeal, just go ahead with Kickstarter. I don't think you need to look any further. If you're going business to business, I probably wouldn't expect you to do so well on Kickstarter. If it's not of international appeal, again, you've got to think if Kickstarter's right. So, but certainly for business to consumer, relatively cheap products or services or rewards, great, Kickstarter's cool. Well, there's a lot more to Kickstarter than crowdfunding.
Right. No, there's like 1,000 of these things now. So what do you think was the thing that you wish you knew now if you started again that you would do differently?
I guess I wish I knew the potential of it is the answer.
Really?
You see, we went to the national press when it started getting a bit more interesting and said, you know, could you cover this? And they said, we'd cover it if the figures were a bit higher. And it's like, well, if you covered it, the figures would be a bit higher. You know what I'm saying?
Chicken and the egg.
I wouldn't necessarily have aimed a lot higher instead of our initial goal, because I think there's a lot to be said for being past your goal. Once you're past your goal, you're in some golden zone where it's self-fulfilling, it's clearly already won. And there's the momentum builds. But I certainly think that I would have talked about bigger numbers to the press earlier. And the Kickstarters that end up doing really well, you often see them in the press, even on their first day, right? They're in the press.
Exactly, yeah, right.
So get a quirky angle on it, I think, and get the press interested so they can cover it almost from the first day.
Now, did you hire a publicist or marketing thing?
No, nobody. No. Just did it myself.
Just did it yourself. So like your course, anybody can learn if they take the time.
Yeah, sure. Just look, it's a popular subject, learning to code. I found the nearest other successful Kickstarter and copy and pasted it precisely. And then I changed only what I had to change to make it ours. And then we talked to our backers a lot. We have over 500 comments on there. We responded to them quickly. We did what they asked for. We kept the excitement going. The momentum just carried on. Every day I spent a little bit of time going onto Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, and other places and asking if they shared the campaign in their groups. And people were very, very welcoming about a Kickstarter.
Oh, really? Wonderful. In other words, you went on LinkedIn or whatever, Facebook, and found relevant groups and said, hey, do you mind if I share this?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, that's it. Well, that sounds logical, right? And it wound up. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
But a lot of our business came straight from. If I look at the backer reports, a lot of it came from Kickstarter itself. They didn't staff pick us. I mean, here's another tip. Ask them to staff pick you, but they may not. They didn't. But something I see people doing all the time when they start Kickstarters is when they do the title and description, this is one of these boring details that matter. If don't waste keywords.
I see.
You know, we made sure we got video games, computer games, online, course, learn, all these words somewhere. It's still got to read right to a person, but don't fill it up with words that people aren't looking for.
The most exciting or whatever and all that kind of stuff. Who cares?
It's got to be words that people are typing in the damn search.
Right.
Don't waste words in that title or subtitle because.
But if we want to know how to code, we have to type in complete. UnityDeveloper.com, right?
Yeah, exactly. That's where you need to go. if you only want to learn to code the fun way. If you want to learn to code in a really boring way, then go and learn how to code spreadsheets or databases or something
all
else.
All that kind of stuff.
And it'll help you get to sleep, but it won't get you.
Well, I'll take Xanax or whatever, but yeah, I'd rather go to CompleteUnityDeveloper.com and find out how to code at like a fraction of what's going to cost you anymore, and have fun doing it, right?
Exactly.
Well, thank you, Ben. Thanks for being over there and across the pond teaching us to have fun.
Thank you.
Take care.
High five.